Okay, it's been 24 hours since I pitched my yeast, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to add 1 teaspoon of yeast nutrient to this must. Now what this is going to do is it's going to provide the yeast with the nutrient that it needs to propagate. So we're just going to add that to my fermenter here. Now, I'm doing it a day after I pitch my yeast. Now, you can do this before you pitch your yeast and let your yeast sit, your must sit for a day, along with some peptic enzyme, and then pitch your yeast 24 hours later. But with this blackberry wine, I went ahead and pitched my yeast, and then now I'm going to add this yeast nutrient 24 hours after I pitched. And you know, you can add it pretty much any time in the fermentation process. It's good if you want to add it before or 24 hours after, but I have seen from one end of the gamut to the other when people add yeast nutrient. So this is diammonium phosphate and urea, and there are a couple different other yeast nutrients out there, but this is the L.D. Carlson yeast nutrient, and it's pretty good stuff. So I added that to my must here 24 hours after I pitch my yeast, and it'll be fine. And this will go 7 days. And then I'll show you what else we have to add and the other things we'll do in this whole wine making process. Okay, real quick, I'm going to show you the wine bottles I'm going to use for this blackberry wine. And these are standard wine bottles. And you know, it doesn't really matter. I know some people may differ, but it doesn't really matter whether you bottle your wine in white or green or brown. It's not like with beer that you have to worry about the oxidation from UV light with beer. You're not going to have to worry about that much with wine. But you know what? I am so used to using darker bottles with beer. When I bought my wine bottles, I went ahead and bought the green anyway. So it's just my personal preference. Rather than using clear bottles. But you can use any color bottles you want for bottling wine. Oh, and as far as corks now, you have number 7s, 8s, and 9s. And now 7s are for wines that you're going to drink within a couple months. 8s are wines you're going to drink between 6 months and a year. And number 9 corks are wines that you're going to age. Now, as far as the length, there's 1.5 and 1.75. You know, it doesn't matter. I use whatever I can get. Usually it doesn't matter if I use 1.75 or 1.5. I'm not sure whether these are 1.5. I think these are 1.5 number 7s.
These are synthetic corks.
As long as you rack your wine correctly and you cork correctly, and then you wait for 24 hours before turning them on their side, I don't think you're going to have any problems with the course you use. But see, I drink the wine so quickly after I bottle that it's never laying around for more than 6 months at the most. So that's just a little bit about wine bottles and corks. Okay, welcome back. It's been 7 days since I started this
blackberry wine in this Mr. Beer container. And I'm only doing a gallon. And I'm going to show you how to strain that and put that in a demijohn. So I don't have to worry about adding anything at this process because I already added my yeast nutrient. And I added that 24 hours after I started. Sometimes I do before, sometimes I do after. But what we're going to do is, I'm hoping that my auto siphon here will be able to work in this little tiny container. I did sanitize everything. Make sure you sanitize all your everything you're going to do. And we're going to brew a batch of beer here in a little bit, so that's why I mixed up all that sanitizer. So everything's been sanitized, and I could technically, in this Mr. Beer, I got a little funnel with a little strain here. I could technically just open that up. But I want to see, because I've never used the Mr. Beer for wine, I want to see if the auto siphon will.
Okay,
work. So what we've done is we've taken the remainder amount of berries and juice out of this this Mr. Beer container. Oh, it smells pretty good. And I got a super fine sieve here. I got several ones. This one's not quite as thick. This one's a little smaller than this one. So I got the one that's in the middle. And we're going to take and dump that rest of those berries in there. I just splashed all the way across the house. Now I'm not going to squeeze those berries. I'm just going to let it naturally drain here. And you can see that was 5 pounds of berries. And, well, actually 4 pounds of berries. And that's all that's left. Woo! That's some strong stuff. So there's not much. I'm going to put a little bit in here. I'm not going to use all this. In fact, that's all I'm going to use. It's not bad. We're going to fill that up to where we want it. And then I'll probably dump the rest of that. I'll re-sanitize this. Berries. We're going to pour some more of that in there. And I think that's where I'm going to be at. Alright, so let me clean this up. When we come back, I'm going to show you the final step. Okay, the final step. After I've strained this wine, this blackberry wine, is I need to put an airlock on top, and it's going to sit in the my brew room for about 3 weeks, and then we're going to rack it, filter it, and rack it. Now, I have these plugs, number sixes, is what this one takes, but currently I only have a 2, a 5, and like a 9. So I've got other things going on with airlocks in there. So what I've got is I've got the cap off of this wine bottle, which is going to be fine because I've added a rubber grommet. And I drilled a hole and added a rubber grommet, and then you can just put the airlock on. That's fine. If you don't want to drill the cap off of the wine, or if you just got a, if you just got a another gallon jug without a top or anything, and you don't have any more plugs, you can take one of these carboy bungs here and you can actually turn it upside down, believe it or not, and shove it on there, and it'll pretty much stay. And then you can do it exactly like that. if you have this size, which I don't remember which size that one was, medium, I think. So if you don't have a stopper and you have a bung for your carboy, you can just turn it upside down over it, make sure it seals really good, and use your airlock. But since I have the cap, which still has the seal underneath, I just drill through the seal and everything, put a rubber grommet in it. I'm going to tighten that on there, and then I'm going to put my airlock. That's if you don't have a rubber stopper. Now the rubber stoppers are only $59.79, $99 from Midwest Brewing. I've got went ahead and ordered a couple more, which are on the way. So if I'm going to be making 1 gallon batches in these bottles, I'm going to need more stoppers. But if you got a lid that'll fit it, you can always improvise. So there it is. It's going to go for 3 weeks like that.
Okay, I went over to the we went over to Elkins, West Virginia tonight, and went over there to get a gallon jug to use as a like a demijohn. So I went and got some Carlo Rossi Chablis. I'll probably use this in cooking, but I wanted, it's a white wine, but I wanted the jar, I wanted the jug for my blackberry wine. But while I was over at Elkins, on the way to Elkins, I stopped in Huntingsville, and look what I got. I got some black spiced rum. Now this is some dark rum, and it's called the Kraken. It says, bizarre and fierce sea creatures, as seen through the eyes of imagination. The Kraken. Down the back it says, the Kraken is imported rum from the Caribbean, blended with natural flavor, named for a sea beast of myth and legend. The Kraken rum is strong, rich, black, and smooth. And how much alcohol is in it? It doesn't say. I don't see it there. It doesn't say how many proof. 94 proof. 47% alcohol by volume. So, we're going. Did you see that? Did you see a little? It's got the Kraken on it. We're going to open this bad boy up right now. It does smell good. Let's give that a taste. Ah. Anyway, I also wanted that bottle too. That is some smooth. Wow. It's almost like cognac. Wow. Wow. That's that's some good stuff. Wow. You can definitely taste. Let me put the camera over here a little bit farther. You can definitely taste the wood flavor. Wow, that's different. You know what? I've never tasted a rum like that, ever. That is totally different. Unbelievable. Anyway, if you go to www.krakenrum.com, it'll tell you who sells it in your area. Wow. That is unbelievable. That is definitely unbelievable. That would be so good with some Coke. You know, that would be good in a lot of drinks. That'd be good in a Bahama Mama. Wow. It's a little picture of a ship up here with the Kraken grabbing it. Anyway, that I wanted, it was $21. $21 for this bottle. It's got Kraken across it. Kraken on the back. Some kind of indentation there. It is a beautiful. Look how dark that is. It's not quite as dark in the glass, but it is. It is the darkest rum I've ever seen. Cognac's feel. You know, you could sip this. That's some good stuff. You know, it's better than Captain Morgan. A lot better. Alright, well, for Tom's Beer Channel, I'm talking Tom Moore. And good luck to you.